Hey, welcome to 12-Tone. Music theorists love naming things. It's how we put them into categories, and it's how we describe their relationships and differences. We especially like naming chords and scales, and we've got some great ones like the Prometheus Scale, the Petrushka Chord, or the Greek Modes. But that's barely scratching the surface. There's just so many out there, most of which have never even been used, at least not in any well-known pieces of music. If we're ever gonna name them all, we'll need to step up our game, and the most famous attempt to do that was by Allen Forte with what are fittingly called Forte Numbers. These were an attempt to systematically name every possible collection of notes so that even if we'd never encountered something before, we could quickly and clearly identify it. But with so many possibilities, naming each one individually would probably be more cumbersome than it was helpful, so first we need to trim the list a bit by grouping similar things together. To start off, let's forget the difference between chords and scales. Don't get me wrong, it's an important distinction, but it's also a somewhat vague one. This scale has all the same notes as this chord. The only difference is how they're used. For this though, use isn't important, so we're lumping them all together and just calling them sets. The next thing we need to lose is the idea of a starting note. When we're talking about structures, specific pitches don't really matter. A D major triad and an E major triad have exactly the same shape, it's just that the second one sits a little higher. We call this a transposition, and for our purposes, it's irrelevant. In order to facilitate that, we don't actually use note names here. Instead, we convert them into numbers which tell you how far above the set's root each note is. So the root itself is 0, a note a half step above it would be 1, then there's 2, 3, and I suspect you've picked up the pattern by now. A major triad, for instance, consists of a 0, a 4, and a 7, while the major scale looks like this. And finally, we don't care how the notes are arranged. You can put them in any order you want. All that matters is which ones you're using. For instance, this, and this are all the same notes, B, D, and F sharp. Even though they sound pretty different, we can describe them all with the same name. With those out of the way, let's look at the actual system Forte used. A Forte number looks like this, and it consists of four pieces of information. The first number tells you how many total notes are in the set, in this case four. Then there's sometimes a Z here, which we'll ignore. It's just a marker for a property certain sets have. The second number is the set's specific identity. Unfortunately, you'll probably just have to look these up. They're in a particular order, but there's no good technique for remembering which number goes to which set, at least not that I'm aware of. And finally, this letter at the end tells you whether or not the set is inverted. What does that mean? Well, we talked about inversions back in our 12-tone writing video. Basically, inverting a set means that you flip all the intervals. Instead of going up, you go down. For example, as we mentioned before, the major triad is the set 0-4-7, which means we have a root, a note 4 half steps above it, and a note 7 half steps above it. To invert that, we again have a root, but this time we have a note 4 half steps below it and another 7 below. And there's a handy trick for this. You just subtract each number from 12 to get its inverted value, giving us 12, 8, 5. If we rearrange that a bit and transpose it to start on 0 again, we get 0, 3, 7, which happens to be a minor triad. So, in a way, we can look at both of these triads as the same basic set, just one of them's upside down. To tell the difference, we call the minor triad 3-11-A, meaning that it's got three notes, it's the 11th set that does, and it's the more compact form of that set. The major triad, on the other hand, is 3-11-B, which means it's the inversion of that same group of intervals. There's also some sets, including the major scale, that have no inversion. If you flip them upside down, you just get the same thing back. These don't get a letter at all, which is kinda sad if you ask me. And that's just one of the interesting things you find when you start looking at sets. Another thing to keep an eye out for is complements, that is, what notes are missing from a set. For instance, if you look at the gaps in the major scale, you find a minor pentatonic hiding in there. And many six-note sets are actually their own complements stuck in the gaps they create. And then there's something called interval vectors and Z relationships, which are really fun to say but probably deserve their own video. All in all, it may get a bit mathy, but musical set theory is a really helpful tool for understanding advanced compositions, and we wouldn't be able to talk about it without Forte numbers. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you want to help make these videos possible, please consider supporting 12-Tone on Patreon. You can also join our mailing list for scans of all our episodes. Like, share, comment, subscribe, and keep on rocking.